swooping in without a hula hoop on a surfboard in the ocean. Oh yeah.
Please stop that.
Tonight's video, we are showing you a weight loss meal plan on a budget that is simple, tasty, and super effective. When I first started my weight loss journey, and for those of you that don't know, I was 275 pounds. I've lost 130 pounds and kept it off for 6 years. When I first started, I needed tasty foods that I could afford because I was on a very strict budget. I also needed it to be simple because anything overwhelming, I would fail. Before I get into this and show you exactly what I ate, I'm also gonna tell you the calories. Don't forget, if you like this content, I would really appreciate a like, a share, a subscribe, hit the bell for notifications so you get more videos. Follow us on Instagram, because you always ask about the camera guy, the cute boy, sassy man behind the camera. Check him out for his face reveal on Instagram. Breakfast. Guys, this stuff is all from Walmart, first of all, and I'm in Canada. So if you're in the States, this is gonna be even cheaper for you. But some of my favorite breakfasts include Quick Oats. Why? Because they are so cheap, you can buy them in bulk. This bag from Walmart is like $2. And if you portion everything out, which is exactly how I lost weight with portion control, it will last you a long time. So $2 is gonna last a very long time.
And I'll give you a quick tip. If you're going bachelor style with the Quick Oats, you don't even need to cook them.
You can literally, yeah, like Kyle just pours them in yogurt. But this is budget stuff. So this is what we're doing. Half a cup of Quick Oats, which I always do about one cup of water, and it expands in volume. So you're actually gonna get like, your oats is gonna expand and your belly is also gonna be full. So this is gonna be tasty and keep you full and keep you on a budget. Then what I like to do is buy frozen fruit, because frozen fruit, like if you buy fresh fruit, it's gonna go bad pretty quick. And in Canada, sometimes in the winter, it's really hard to get certain fruits. So this bag is like $8 or $9 here at Walmart, and it lasts a really long time if you measure it out. So I put half a cup of these, I thaw them in the microwave, and what happens is the juice, when it thaws out, it actually flavors the oatmeal, so don't need any sweetener. If you wanna splurge, you can get a big bag of sweetener at Walmart. It's the no calorie sweetener for very cheap. It's like $11. It lasts forever.
These are like the extras. If you don't need them.
No.
If you're going real basic, you don't need them, but these are like if you want to get fancy.
Yeah, but if you don't, the juice from the thawed berries, it flavors the oats. I chose strawberries because they're the lowest in calorie, but you can choose any frozen fruit that you want. Then we've got large eggs, 2 of them. You can cook them however you like. I like mine like crunchy. So I like put them in the pan and get them all crispy and then flip it and crisp it again. Kyle does not approve of that method.
When you said crunchy, I left the room for a second.
I knew when you went quiet, I knew you were like.
You meant crispy, right? Because crunchy would mean like you left the shell on or something.
Crispy. So eggs are like super cheap. They're complete, like whole food. You got good fat in there, you've got good protein, and they're super cheap. You can get a ton of eggs at Walmart for a very good deal. This is like, what, $2 at Walmart? A little over in Canada? You can probably get them way cheaper in the States. So 2 eggs, half a cup of oatmeal, half a cup of berries. That will stay in your belly, stick to your ribs, keep you full. It's a balanced meal. It's got good fats, carbs, strawberries for fruities. You're good to go. Snack. Now this is where I do buy the fresh fruit, because bananas are super cheap. You can buy them in bulk. They're tasty. And if you get a size like this, like a small size.
I have a small size. Oh, for bananas, okay.
It's a good, we're on bananas. This is a PG channel, okay? This is a good size banana if you're trying to lose weight and stay in portion.
I would say like half of that is very good size, but that's probably, guys, this is like the best size to have, but that's a pretty good.
Guys.
But bananas too, also, they pack a big punch nutrition-wise for, you know, potassium and stuff.
Potassium. Also, they're tasty. Like, again, I had to like my food. I needed to be able to stick to this. Simple, tasty, and on a budget.
Yeah, even though we're going basic, you still want it to be tasty.
Still want to be tasty. Like, you can get other fruit, but bananas are super cheap. Even in Canada, they're really cheap, and they're easy to find. And a protein bar. Not only, like, we get a box of six of these.
And these, in Canada anyways, the pure protein are the cheapest
and
that we can find.
They're the cheapest and they're the best macros. Like, we like to stay under 200 calories per protein bar and under 5 grams of fat for a bar. And these are about 19 to 20 grams of protein, which is really good. And it's a great snack when you pair it with a fruit or a veggie, like, so I paired it with the banana. It keeps you full and satisfied. And for six of them, it's about $8 here, but they go on sale for $6 to $7 quite often. So in the States, you're probably gonna find them for way cheaper. And they come in a ton of different flavors.
And for like $1 a day, you can't go wrong with that.
$1 a day, it's lots of protein.
If you live in a world, if you live in a world where there's 6 days in a week, then $1 a day.
Oh yeah, we
close enough.
We're not mathematicians, did we?
You know, you get the point. It's close enough.
Yeah, we're not mathematicians. It's fine. We still lost weight. We're good. Okay, so protein bar and a banana for a snack. Moving on to lunch. This was actually like tuna sandwich is what I'm gonna show you, but tuna sandwiches are like the bee's knees. Super cheap, super simple to make. There's no cooking. You literally throw it all together. It is such a good meal too, balance wise. So we always get the chunk light tuna or the flaked light. It doesn't matter, but it has to be in water because if you get it in oil, you're adding a ton of calories. And Walmart, like in Canada, when they go on sale, they're like 80 cents. So I'm sure you can find them cheaper in the States.
And just check like any brand, any tuna in water is good.
As long as it's in water, yeah. So anything, if you see a sale, like we used to buy cases when they would go on for 80 to 90 cents, a can, and we're gonna do half a can here. So one can for like 80 cents lasts you 2 days.
Such good clean protein.
Lean protein, half a can of tuna with a tablespoon of mayo. Here you can get a big jar for like $3 to $4, like even bigger than this for $3 to $4. If you buy light, you're probably gonna pay more. So if you're on a budget and you portion it out, you can have the regular with no problem at all because you're portioning.
Yeah, and you still need fats in your diet.
Yes. And in the beginning, I didn't buy light. I used what I had in my house. And mayo, full fat mayo was it. So one tablespoon with half a can of tuna. It's gonna flavor your tuna really nicely. Two slices of bread. I like to choose the lowest calorie. This is our current favorite kind. This is the Villaggio Artisano bread. But you can get any regular bread for the cheapest price. Just find the cheapest bread that's fairly low in calories. This is 150 calories for two slices. You know, so if you find something like that for cheap, you can buy bread for $2 or less, and a whole loaf is gonna last you a long time because we're portioning it out. So two slices, half a can of tuna, a tablespoon of mayo, makes you a nice tuna sandwich full of protein and tastiness. And then we need to add some veggies to keep you full, and veggies are good for you. 1 cup of cucumber. I like to put salt on it. Kyle likes salt, pepper, and vinegar. I'm just the salt, like just as much salt as you can fit on them. 1 cup. And that's actually 2 servings of veggies. So that's really good. That's gonna keep you satisfied, full. It's also a balanced meal. You've got your carbs, protein, veg, and some fat. What? Next, rice. We bought club-sized bags of rice for years on our weight loss journey because you can get a bag like this for $10 or less. And this is just regular white rice. A lot of people like focus on getting like the whole grain and all of that, but when you're on a budget, typically like the regular stuff, the white stuff of rice or bread, the full fat males, those are gonna be
like,
cheaper.
You can, people get real fancy, but if your belly can tolerate just normal oats, get the quick oats, the you know, the great value is the cheapest. Steel cut and all that is gonna run you like way, almost double the price of those.
Yeah, so when we're going budget, this is the stuff to do. If you're portioning it out, it's not gonna make a difference.
It's just as effective.
Yes, this is about weight loss, not health. It's two different things. A lot of people are concerned that this is not healthy. White rice, brown rice, doesn't matter. It's never made a difference for us, as long as it's in portion. So we're gonna make a stir fry, and you're gonna be shocked at what we're gonna make it with. What? Cost-effective meat. Here to buy these frozen burgers at Walmart. These are the lean chicken burgers. This, you get a box of 8 for about $10, and that is very good here. Now, a lot of you, when we show these, say that you can't find them, so you don't have to get the exact thing. Just find a cheap, lean burger. It can be turkey, it can be chicken,
if lean, you even whatever. Like a beef, if you can find like an extra lean beef burger, it's fine. It's, you know, like your calorie wise, we're at around 1600, you said, for this.
Yeah,
you're gonna have room to play.
Yeah, and this, you know, that's an estimate. It's gonna, it's about 1600 calories for everything that I'm gonna show you here. And that's just, you know, give or take. If you switch something out, it's gonna obviously affect it. It's just an estimate. If you're, as long as you're portioning it out, you eat one burger, it's not gonna make a difference. It's portions, it's being in a calorie deficit that helps you lose the weight.
So we always get comments from people saying it's too expensive to eat healthy. Well, this is all healthy and clean, and it's very cheap. And the people that usually tell us that, we find out they go out to fast food, buy a lot of, you know, extra processed stuff and junk at the grocery store. That's way more expensive than this stuff.
And then they're concerned about things being organic and stuff too, usually. And so we don't need to worry about that. It's about being in a calorie deficit, liking what you eat, simple, cheap.
If your diet now is Dairy Queen and then you're yelling at us for non-organic stuff, it doesn't really make sense.
No, so just do this.
No, don't do this, don't listen to us.
Oh, sorry, don't listen to me, I don't know what I'm talking about. I have no papers, I'm a paperless freak. I'm not a doctor or nutritionist. I'm just a me that lost 130 pounds and I'm wearing llama slippers, so don't listen.
Yeah.
So one chicken burger, cooked, obviously, please cook it if you're gonna eat this. And then put into 1 cup of cooked white rice. So I measure out the rice when it's cooked, and it was 1 cup I always ate.
Yeah, this diet is similar to what we did, so don't do this at all. Don't listen to us.
Nope, this is what I ate. I'm just entertaining you with what I ate, okay? So this is how much I measured out cooked, 1 cup. And then 1.5 cups of veggies. Now, frozen veggies are much more economical. They're better on a budget because, just like the frozen fruit, they last longer. You can buy a bunch of big bags, club size bags, and throw them in your freezer. But you can also find at your market, but at Walmart, you can get a lot of cheap veggies. We buy the peppers, the red and orange peppers, by the pound, and they're pretty cheap. They're, for three of them, they're about $3 or $4, and they last us forever. Mushrooms are very cheap here, and you don't have to buy them already sliced. You can buy them just a big bunch of button mushrooms and it'll be cheaper.
And keep in mind, this is Canadian dollars, so divide this in like half and then you'll know what you're paying in the States.
That's why I keep saying in the States it's cheaper, because I'm in Canada. It's expensive here. Onion. You can get like this is a big onion, and you can get this for a very cheap, like a buck or less. So you can get a few onions. Spinach, if you buy it like this, the pre-washed baby spinach, it's a little more expensive. But if you buy the bags of spinach, they're way cheaper. So spinach, pepper, onion, mushroom, super cheap. Throw it into a stir fry, use cooking spray, it's less calories than oil. And then for a snack, this is something we've literally been having since the beginning of our journey. We have it every night.
The best before bed snack on the planet.
Cottage cheese, 1% cottage cheese with a tablespoon of peanut butter. We eat the natural peanut butter now, but we started with regular peanut butter. You can get peanut butter at the dollar store. So, but at Walmart, it's very cheap too. So, this is so good. Protein and fat, slow digesting all night long is gonna keep you, your muscles, loving life. So the friends, this is it. It's approximately 1600 calories. This is exactly what I ate. Cheap, simple, on a budget, effective. I lost weight. Like I said, I've lost 130 pounds, kept it off for 6 years.
Oh yeah, if you get fancy with the cottage cheese, you can throw in some cocoa powder and some Great Value sweetener, which is what we do.
So the splurgies, we do this. Cocoa powder, a teaspoon, and a teaspoon of sweetener in the cottage cheese if you want to get a little splurgy. Another bonus, low calorie and super cheap, are rice cakes. Sometimes we switched up the bread for our tuna and put tuna on the white cheddar rice cakes. That is very good, and these are super cheap and come in a ton of flavors. Another very cheap thing, if you are working out and you want a pre-workout or you just like coffee, we make our own coffee from home, and that saves so much money. And the Maxwell House and—
The dark, you gotta get the dark.
If you're a coffee connoisseur, you gotta get the dark, but if you're not, don't.
So buy the big tins, make the coffee yourself.
It's a great pre-workout. It's also just, coffee's just good. All right, dear friends, if you wanna know exactly what I ate and Kyle ate to lose our first and next 50 pounds, check out our weight loss guides down below. Exact meals, portions, family-friendly recipes, it's all in there. Watch these two videos. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and do this, shake it out.
Jump. Whoa.
Love life. You can love your food. You can make it simple and cheap. Lawn, more action. Love ya. See you next time. Peace.
See you guys.
See ya. Remember the friends that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.